Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and today I'm gonna show you how to make this universal joint and how to assemble it. So these are the components and here is the drawing we'll be following. This is the fork, the center block, the pin and the collar and the tupper pin. First we'll start with the center block and then the fork, the pin, the collar and the tupper pin. So let's begin. We'll have to open a new part in SolidWorks. And here for the center block we'll open a sketch in the front plane first. Here we'll make two circles. And with smart dimension we'll dimension them. This one will have 56 millimeters in diameter and this one 30. And now we'll go to features and we'll use extruded boss base. And here at blind we'll select mid plane. And the length will be 106 millimeters. And press OK. Now let's make this plane height. Nice, now we'll have to open a sketch in the top plane. And we'll have to make the same thing. Two circles. Just like this, the same diameters, 56 and 30 millimeters. And now the dimension between these two center points, here will be 38 millimeters. And now to fully define this sketch, we'll have to select these two points and to make them horizontal. Now this is fully defined. Go to features and use extruded boss base. Here we'll keep also mid plane and the length will be also 106 millimeters. Nice. Now we'll have to cut this extra material inside both of these cylinders. So open a sketch on this face first, select convert entities command, convert this edge, press OK and then go to features and use extruded cut. And here we can keep 106 and press OK. This one is clean. We'll have to do the same thing for this one. So open a sketch on this face, convert entities command, convert this edge, press OK. And now go to features and use extruded cut. And here also 106. And here blind. Press OK. And now this one is also clean. Now on the drawing is not here is not applied any fillet, but I will make a fillet here. So select fillet, we'll keep the radius 5 millimeters and select this edge and press OK. Now it's looking better. Now we can make this from a material, we can apply some appearance. So go here to metal and we'll choose polished steel. Double click on it or you can drag it on this and select here part. Which part is it? Nice. And now we'll have to save this. So save it. Save it on my desktop. This is the center block. Okay. And now we'll have to make the fork. So open another part in SolidWorks. And for the fork, we're gonna make, first we'll make this rectangle, this base here. Then we'll make this cylinder. And then we'll make these two other parts. So let's begin. First we'll open a new sketch in the front plane and here we'll make a center rectangle. This one will have the dimensions, here will be 88 and here will be 106 plus 56, 162. Okay, and now we'll just have to load features and use extruded boss base. The thickness will be 30 millimeters and press OK. Let's make this plain white. And on this side we'll make the cylinder. So open a sketch on this face, normal 2. And here we'll make 2 circles. Select this circle and this line, edge, and select here make tangent. This one have the diameter 88, and this one will have the diameter 50 millimeters. Nice, now we'll have to make these 3 lines here. Select this point and this circle and select here make coincide. Make these 2 equal. And now with smart dimension we'll define this. Here will be, we'll say 10 millimeters. And from this point to the center point, here will be 28. Okay, and now with remain this command will cut this part of the circle. And now go to features and use extruded boss base, and here will be 55 millimeters. That's okay. Nice, and almost done. Now we'll open a sketch on this face, normal 2, and here we'll make 2 circles first. These 2 circles will have the diameters, this one will have 38 plus 38, 76, and this one will have 30 millimeters. Okay, I'm sorry for my mistakes. And now select these 2 points and select here make vertical. And now the dimension from this center point to this edge, here will be 130 millimeters. Now select line and make a line starting from this point tangent to this circle. So make it tangent, and then make another one on this side and one here. Okay, and now we'll have to cut this part of the circle. So select trim entities command and cut this. Nice. Now this sketch is fully defined. We'll go to features and we'll use extruded boss base. And we'll have to select here reverse direction, and the thickness will be 28 millimeters. And press OK. Now we'll have to mirror this extruded body on this side. So select mirror. At mirror face plane, we'll select top plane and features to mirror boss extruded tree. Press OK. And now the fork is done. We'll have to save this one also. So this is fork 1. And now we'll have to make the pin. So open a new part. And we'll open a sketch in the front plane. We'll make here a circle. This will have the diameter 50 millimeters. Now go to features and use the extruded boss base. And here the thickness will be 12 millimeters. Press OK. And now we'll open another sketch on this face. And here we'll make a circle with the diameter 30 millimeters. And And then we'll go to features and we'll use extruded boss base. And here the length will be 180 mm. And press OK. Now we'll have to open a sketch in the top plane, normal tool, and here we'll make a circle which will be the hole for the tapper pin. So select circle, and this will have the diameter 5 mm, and from this center point to this edge here will be 12 mm. Nice, now to fully define this, we'll have to select this point and this one and select here make vertical. And now this is fully defined. Go to features and use extruded cut. And here at blind we'll select through all both and press OK. Nice. Now save this as pin. And now we'll have to make the collar, so open a new part. Now we'll open a sketch in the top plane. Here we'll make two circles with the diameters. This one will have 30 mm and this one will have 50. And now just simply go to features and use extruded boss base. Here the thickness will be 12. Press OK. And now we'll have to make the same thing. We'll have to make the hole here for the pin, for the tapper pin. So open a sketch in the front plane, normal tool. And here select circle and make one circle like this. OK, select these two points and make them vertical. This circle will have the diameter 5 mm. And now to fully define this, we'll have to make a center line starting from this center point and until the middle of this edge, and now make this center line vertical, horizontal, sorry. And now this is fully defined. Go to features and use extruded cut, and here also instead of blind keep through all both and press OK. And now the color is done. Let's save this one. And now we only have the tapper pin remaining to make. So open a new part and here select front plane, open a sketch, and here we'll make a circle with diameter 5 mm. And then go to features and use extruded boss base, and the length will be 60 mm. Press OK, and now we'll have to save it. Tapper pin 1. And these are all the parts, so we'll go back to fork. And we'll go to this arrow, go to file, select here make assembly from part, and we'll have to place it, so click, one click to place it. Let's make this plain white. And now we'll have to insert the other components, so go to insert components and select center block, collar, pin and tapper pin. And you'll have to click once for each one of them. Okay, and now we'll have to assemble them. So first we'll select this face with this face, and we'll select here make concentric. Then we'll select this face with this one and select here coincide. Nice. Now we'll have to insert this pin inside the fork and the center block. So select this face with this one and select here concentric. And now this face with this one and select here coincide. Nice. Now I'll have to put the color here. So select this face with this one and select here concentric. Okay. So now we cannot see it anymore. Let's hide this center block. So select this one and go here to change transparency. And now we can see the color. And we'll just drag it up. And then select this face with this one from the pin. And select here concentric. Nice. Now change the transparency again. And now we'll have to insert the pin in this hole. So select this face from the pin with this one, select here concentric. Nice. And now we'll have to make these two parts equal. So for this we'll go to mate. Here we'll go to advanced mates. We'll select here width. And first we'll select this face with this face. And then we'll select this face from the color. And now these two ends are equal, and press OK. And now we have first part. We have to multiply this four, this and this other three parts. So to multiply a part here, we'll have to keep the control pressed and then left click and drag it. And now we have to rotate this, so go to move components, rotate component, and just rotate it like this. Press it OK, and then we have to assemble it here. So select this face with this one and select here concentric. OK, and then select this face with this one and select here coincide. Nice. Now we'll have to multiply the pin, so control pressed, click and drag it. Okay, so where is it? Okay, now select this face with this one and make them concentric. And now this face with this one and select here coincide. Now we are doing exactly the same thing which we already done with this first part, with this first fork and pin and collar and upper pin. So it's the same thing, the same mates. Okay, now we'll have to multiply the collar, so control pressed, left click and drag. And now select this face with this one and select concentric. Then these two, also concentric. And now the last part, the pin, the upper pin. Select this face with this one and make them concentric. And now the last mate. Go to mate, go to advanced mates, and go to width. And here we'll select these two faces, and then the face from the color. Press OK. And now this is done. This universal joint. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. And if you like it, you can leave a like, you can subscribe if you want to see more tutorials, and I'm waiting for you in the next video. Thank you, and I hope to see you there.